Praise God. Next verse. Let the word of Christ dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, and singing with the grace in your hearts to the Lord. And whatever you do in words or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus, giving thanks to God the Father through him. Let's believe and pray. Father, we thank you. I give you glory and I give you honor. You are such a great dad for us, Lord, and that's why the far we have come, we give you thanks. As I minister to your people, Lord, I pray that you alone speak to us. Lord, I step aside that you may be able to prevail and be able to deliver this message, Lord, in a way and in a manner in which you purpose it to come. For I know it will not go back in void. And Lord, I thank you and I give you glory for this. I pray in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Thank you. Praise God, church. As I've said, that time such as this, especially in December, I know we hardly like have a week or two to be able to close the year. And all that we can say is to thank God. I think I will summarize it today. I say do not have a sermon, but just thank the Lord because of who he is. I know a lot of us started off very well in the year, but some have fallen off. You know, others have not been able to come so far. I mean, the far that we are. And today I see it just a time for us to be able to just give thanks to the Lord because of who he is. This God has been good. This God has been faithful. This God has been God. And that's why I said I will just come and tell the church that let's thank the Lord. Because the far that we are, it's taken his hands. I know one thing that I know with Paul, he tried this so many times in the various letters that he writes to the church, that every time you come before the Lord is to come with thanksgiving. It will be able to appreciate God and to express the heart of gratitude to him. Praise God. I may not know exactly what you are thanking God for, but one thing I know, the fact that you are alive today, the fact that you have your family intact, the fact that at least you've been able to have your job still, you have a reason to just bless the name of the Lord. And then that's why I say it would be good for us to appreciate that when you come to the house of the Lord, when you come to the church, just as moments where we have found ourselves in his presence, it is never in vain. I know very well that you have so much you can appreciate God for. Praise God. That even if it's not just your personal life, you are people around you. You are people around your life that you looked at their lives at the beginning of the year and you've reached a point where you say the far that so and so has reached, it is God. And for that matter, I thank the Lord because of my friend so-and-so. Praise God. It is not just always about you. I know you will thank the Lord for healing your mother, protecting your father, keeping your aunties and everyone else around you. But then your friends that you saw even in the beginning of the year, writhing in pain, going through difficult times, but for some reason they got an opportunity to thank the Lord. You alone can be able to join hands with that person, to just thank God because of what you can see in the people's lives around your life. Praise God. We were told here in the morning that when you come to the house of the Lord, come with gladness and just come with joy and just sing the songs of joy to the Lord. It is important for us to appreciate that indeed it is not in our might or in our strength that the fact that we have come, that we've been able to do it ourselves. But this is the works and the doing of the Lord. Praise God. If you look at what the Bible is saying, if you begin, it says that, and let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which also you are called in one body, and be thankful. Praise God. It is not always obvious that you will have peace. It is not always automatic that you will be at peace. I know sometimes you desire that you have a whole week without any issue. But for some reason, you realize that the devil, who is a liar, and who is always pursuing us very much incessantly, we'll always throw in a lot of stuff on our way. But I thank the Lord because the Lord has given us peace in our hearts. He says that let the peace of God rule in your hearts, to which you also we are called in one body, and be thankful. Praise. We thank God because of the Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. And for some reason, we were objects of wrath. We were supposed to be punished. But I would say because of his grace, we can thank him this morning. Praise God. That we thank him because of who he is. Next verse. He says that let the word of Christ dwell in you richly, in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and in hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to the Lord. Praise God. That every time you sing, every time you express your love to God, you will express it knowing very well that you are doing it unto the Lord. Praise God. That we are still here, that let us let the word of God dwell in us richly. Because he is the God, he is the Prince of Peace. He is the protector of our lives. He is the deliverer of our people. And therefore, we will be able to thank the Lord that we found ourselves as members of the church here today. That we've all traveled this journey in the course of the year, where we had so much happening. We had a lot of sicknesses and diseases that that people were facing. But for some reason, I would say we have come to a point where we can call it that God, indeed, the way far we have come, we will thank you. And therefore, let's be able to just support each other. Let's encourage each other. Because let the word of the Lord dwell in our hearts richly. Praise God. That as we sing the psalms, hymns, and songs, and everything else, we are told here, we do it with grace in our hearts. Praise God. That we will be able to just thank the Lord because of a friend. I always say it's not always an automatic occurrence. That you all wake up in the morning and all is well. You thank the Lord because of your wife. You thank the Lord because of your children. You thank the Lord because of your friend. You go back to work and you just see your friend. So much is happening. And therefore, just thank the Lord because of what he's doing. Praise God. Next verse. And verse 17, it says that, and whatever you do in word or deed, do all in the name of the Lord Jesus. Praise God. That giving thanks to God the Father through him. Praise God. That we are told that everything that we do, we thank God. That if we have some work to do with our hands, I will thank the Lord that he has given me something to do. I will thank the Lord because whatever I'm doing, it is because of his might. It is because of his strength. And therefore this year, as you come to the end of year 2021, you have all the reason to bless the name of the Lord. You have the reason to give him gratitude. You have the reason to express your love for him because he is faithful and he is good God. Praise God. Give me Psalms 103, 1 verse 1 to 5. Psalms 103. Yeah, the Bible says, bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Praise God. You know, you can come to a point where you have nothing to express, to speak about, but just to say my heart, bless the Lord. You just want to thank God because he's everything in your life. That this God has been faithful, he's covered you, he's protected you, he's been able to just cover you. And therefore you say that my heart, my soul, may you bless the Lord. Praise God. In verse 2, he says something here in verse 2. Our systems are good, good. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Because, you know, sometimes people forget the benefits of serving God. People forget the benefits of salvation. People forget the benefits of just being alive. And therefore, I would imagine myself without salvation. I don't know where I would be today. I'm not even sure whether I would be in existence. But there's so much that has come up along with me because of just knowing this Christ. But because of he's been able to just guide my footsteps. He's been able to show me his ways. And therefore I would thank the Lord because of all he's been able to do in my life and the life of my family. And therefore the Bible says that as you come to the end of the year, as you come to finish this year, may you be able to just count the blessings of the Lord. May you count the benefits of knowing God. It is never in vain that you, in such a moment such as this, in this morning, you wake up in the morning when it's chilly, when it's, you know, in a city like this with too much traffic, you just come to the house of the Lord. It is because there's so much benefit of knowing God. There is fullness of joy in his presence. There is just so much you can count by knowing God. And therefore, I would say this year, as you finish strong. It doesn't matter whether you did achieve whatever you wanted. I also had some things that I wanted to achieve. But all that I can say, 2022 is still there. As long as he gives me life. As long as he is still with me. As long as God is still God. I will do everything through him who strengthens me. I will go into 2022 knowing very well that there is God in heaven. That there is God is watching over our lives. And therefore we will bless the name of the Lord. And I will not forget all his benefits. There's so much benefit in serving God. Praise God. You know, I always tell people that it's so sad when you notice. You know, some people always juggle whether to serve God or not. But I always tell people, you will find it so hard when you notice there is heaven and you didn't serve him. He would rather you will not run at a loss, even if you serve him and there is no heaven, because you are safe in him. You are safe serving God. It's just too much benefit knowing God. I know I have tested him, and I know the Lord is good. And therefore he says that, bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Praise God. Next verse, verse 3. He says that who forgives all your iniquities, who heals all your diseases. How many of you were sick this year? Who told you that that small disease would have not graduated to something serious? But for some reason, the Lord our God came and dealt with it and handled it in good time. That he heals all your diseases. You may have suffered any loss, some loss. You may have sinned or something might have happened in the year. But this God who forgives. I know we are not perfect. But for some reason, somewhere you add, you went wrong. I mean, you did something which was not good. But the Lord our God, who is full of mercy, this God who is faithful, is able to forgive. And therefore, because of that, I will thank the Lord. Because of that, I will lift his name. Because of that, I will praise the Lord. And therefore, I say, as we come to the end of 2021, you can look at the year, you can reflect back and say, it's such and such a man. There's a time I expressed myself in a way that did not really present the precepts of the Lord. Sometimes I was able to speak things which were not able to exalt the name of the Lord. But I would say this, God, even if it is in thoughts, sometimes as human beings, we ask so much that sometimes you wonder, this will this God forgive? But I would say, we thank the Lord that he's been able to protect us. Some of us caught COVID. I know friends, even people we work with, but for some reason they survived. You cannot take that for granted. It is not because God did not love the ones who passed on, but I will thank him because he heals all my diseases. It doesn't matter which disease it could be. It could be a mental issue. It could be depression. It could just be a challenge that you're going through in your life. It can just be stress. It can just be the issue of losing a loved one. But I will thank the Lord that despite the fact that things happen in the year, I will forget everything else, but just look at the benefits of the Lord. I will focus on his goodness. I will look at the benefits of serving this God. In verse 4. In verse 4, it says that who redeems your life from destruction. You know, redemption is not an easy. You bargain, somebody puts a price on your life. And then somebody comes and say, yes, who can be able to pay this? And the Lord Jesus Christ, who is able to redeem our lives. He says that he redeems your life from the destruction. He says that, the Bible says, I think in the book of 1 Peter, that it is not by the perishable things that you are redeemed. You know, it is not by these things like silver and gold, but it is by the precious blood of Jesus Christ, the Lamb without blemish. He was identified before the foundations of the earth, but he has been revealed this time. Times because of you. This goodness of this Christ. He was identified almost many years, but for some reason he's been made known to us in these current times because of your life. And therefore, as you serve the Lord, he has redeemed you from destruction. Some of you, there were just things that happened for some reason, and you did not get to a journey which would have really taken your way, your life. And that's why I say, thank this God who crowns you with loving kindness. Praise God. It is not easy to crown people. You know, people have to work very hard for them to get a crown. Praise God. There is some things that goes in toiling for somebody to put a crown on your head. For you to graduate, you must work hard. Praise God. But I love this God because for some reason, he has identified me among men and he's lifted me in a way that I would be able to just thank him. And therefore, his loving kindness is such a great that I will not forget about this God. He says that, and tender mercies. You know, there are mercies that are tender. He looks at you and says, this is a very delicate child of mine. This is a baby of mine. I will protect him. I will cover him. I will live for him to serve him. I mean, just to protect him during this difficult time. And therefore, this God who redeems us. Praise God. It is not by perishable things. If it is money, we would have bought it. I know if it is resources, we would have tried our best. I know people who passed on in the year who had all the resources. But for some reason, it is not by the perishable things like silver and gold. He said it is not by those things, but by the precious of the blood of Christ Jesus, a lamb without blemish. Because this Christ Jesus who was founded from the beginning has now been made known to us. And therefore, as we serve him because he is faithful. We lift his name because he is good God. Praise God. In verse 5, as we go on, he says, who satisfies your mouth with good things? Praise God. You know, it is not always that you eat good things, Rev. You know, sometimes people eat food, but they endure. They eat things because you are so desperate. You've not reached a level, you still suffer hunger. But people have reached a level where they are past hunger. We are now dealing with nutrition. We are saying that you have to talk about balance diet. It reaches a level where you eat anything. where you have to go for anything because you have to survive. But I pray this God who can be able to give us abundance, that this God who can feed us with the goodness, we can be able to just give us that which everyone else is enjoying outside there. It is not every day that you get what you eat. But the Lord our God, it is not just always obvious that you'll be able to even speak things that will be able to bless. But this God can give you wisdom. This God can give you the right message. That as you speak to people, you become a blessing. As you express your word to people, you become you touch people's lives. And therefore we thank the Lord who can satisfy our mouths. It is not obvious that you'll be able to have something good in your mouth. He says, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. Praise God. We know how the eagles are. When they get old, you find that even their claws cannot be able to hold. Their claws, their talons, and everything else, they have to remove them. They have to kind of shed them off, and then they rejuvenate their lives. That is what the Bible is saying, that you will be able to mount high again. You will come to 2022. People will wonder why. This guy, we didn't think he would be such a person, but Ikumbe was retreated. But when he got into 2022, we were surprised the power to which we come with. He came in with power. He came in with strength, because this God renewed his strength. He will be able to, so that your youth is renewed. Praise God. All of us wants to become young. There is no reason. No one would want to become old. Because when you are a young person, you can run fast. When you are young, you can go for something. You can become a go-getter when you are a young person. Praise God. This is one thing that I bless the Lord for. Praise God. That he is keeping us in our good shape. He is keeping us in our good skin. That our hairs and everything else, we can still become presentable. But I will say he has the strength of a young person in our lives because of this God. It is not obvious that you wake up in the morning and you have the confidence, the power to just go and work. Sometimes we get so weak. You imagine again tomorrow is another day. And you wake up in the morning, you feel you are worn out. You are so tired. But the Lord will can be able to give you strength. But you go for another day and you say, the Lord, you will bless me as I go out. That as I come back, I will come back with something. Because you renew my youth. You will renew my strength. It is the God our Lord who can be able to renew you like an eagle. Praise God. That when you go for to take something, you will come back home and your children will be happy. That dad went out, but he came home with something. Because that's what the eagles do. They go for their prey, they come back with something. I pray this year that as we finish, may the Lord our God remind us of his goodness. That whatever he's been able to do, it is not because we were so intelligent. It is never because we are so connected. But I pray that we are get connected to the Lord. Because his benefits, his greatness, his goodness surpasses all. He says that give thanks to the Lord, for his goodness endures forever. He is good God who never cuts short his supplies. He is one God that once you know him, you are done. You know him, you are sorted. You know him, you are finished. Because he's good God, I know the Lord that we are serving. And therefore the Bible says that my soul, oh bless the name of the Lord because of who he is to us. Praise God. That don't finish this year thinking that you are in your own ways that you've been able to make it. We still have a few weeks to go, or a week or so. But this God is the one who will be able to just take us through this year. And we will come towards the end of the year as we close the year and just continue thanking him. Because this is a month of expressing our gratitude to the Lord. Praise God. Can somebody give me Psalms 95? And then I'll give you a few things. In fact, before you give me Psalms 95, give me Psalms 116. 116, 12, 13. The Bible says that if you give me King James Version, or even this is okay, this New King James, is that what shall I render to the Lord for all his benefits towards me? What shall I give to the Lord? What shall I give back to the Lord? You know, sometimes you cannot be able to outgive God. You cannot be able to reward God. It's just really giving thanks because he's done so much. Is it something you can be able to give back to the Lord? For he has given me so very much that I will be able just to really just give him thanks. That is the one thing that I wanted us to understand. That what is it that you can pay the Lord? You cannot bribe him. You cannot be able to just be able to do something magic. It is just the Lord that you thank him this year. That what shall I give you? God, you've done so much. You protected me. Sometimes you go on the road and you have no idea. I would tell you so many times that I've been flying, and sometimes you think you're enjoying. I've always held my heart like hell. Praise God. A number of times I travel from Kisumu in the evenings, and the rains are up. In fact, at one point, we started taking off. That's like 2 or 3 weeks ago. Then the plane just had some breakdown. We had to wait for another flight from Nairobi to come. We're leaving Kisumu around midnight because, you know, there's nothing you would do. You can imagine, and we're told all to disembark again. And I thank the Lord that it's good we disembarked. I'm one person that I don't want to take chances. I know what it means, because once you go mid-air, you have no idea. And this pilot tells us we have to wait for another flight to come. And then you wait patiently, you wait. So it's not always good that when you fly, you think you are safe. You think when you're driving, you think you are safe. I'm telling you, it is all about God. It's not always because you think you are so smart. There is no where you have no idea where the enemy is lacking. He's just be able to, he's looking for somebody to devour. And therefore, thank God because of who he is. Praise God. Many times we eat even foods in hotels, we have no idea what the cooks have done. And if they choose to do anything, you know, somebody once said that you just thank the Lord. Sometimes by faith, we eat things. If you could imagine, you go to the kitchen of these hotels, somebody who is evil can decide to do anything. Even if they urinate on that food, you will eat it. And by for some reason, the Lord will protect you. Because when you drink poison, you will not die. When you catch serpents, for some reason, this God will cover you. This God will be able to remain faithful. I know what happens. Sometimes you have no idea. If the wife decides to do anything to you, it is by faith as a husband you will eat. You have no idea, but the Lord is God. I will say, even if I drink poison, I will be able to get well. Because this God is God. Thank God. Praise God. That is the thing that I believe in. It is never safe. Any place we go to, you sleep in the night, you have no idea what people are planning. But I thank the Lord. A few times I've been home because I'm campaigning. I've told you that twice I've woken up in the night and have to leave my home going to sleep in Kisumu because of some intelligence, because of some reason. And it is too early. We are going to a place where it is a matter of God to be with me. You will have to think, you have to get the intelligence, you have to get the thing. Because if you make small mistake, these guys will go for you. But I praise the Lord because he's faithful. The God who can be able to protect me. Because God is the Lord who gives us the strength even to make wealth. He is the God who can be able to cover us. I know so many times we've planned good plans. But for some reason midway, things just go south. But I say the Lord is faithful. Even in that, there is a reason. Because there is everything that works for the good of them who love him and are called according to his purpose. And therefore, I've snapped a point where I just say, oh, bless the Lord, oh, my soul. Because he is good. Because for some reason, I can't express my, you know, I can't speak it. He is God. Praise God. And that's one thing I pray, that even as you go home this December, to trust God, you get protected. There are magicians and witch doctors. People who are sitting down. They are just planning to finish somebody. In fact, for some reason, there are people who want to punish your parents through you. Because they passed on and there were things they did. I always say, sometimes it's not your own problem. But some people are so much bitter with your parents that they want to punish you. Punish your parents through you. Praise God. They are coming for you because of what somebody else did. They are coming for your life, not because you messed up with their lives, but because they are in your family, they have a beef with that. And therefore, they want to do everything else. But I pray that God is able to protect us. That I say that blessed in the name of the Lord. The Bible says somewhere, I think in Psalms, most likely, I think 107 or 102, it says that let the redeemed of the Lord say so. That let the blessed of the Lord say so. That I am covered, I am protected in the name of the Lord. Praise God. I want to give you three things that you must capture as you go home. Why? How you express your thanksgiving to God. How we can express our thanksgiving to God. Number one, through testimonies. Because you have to tell us exactly what the Lord has done for you. This God has invested his love over your life. And you come here, and he's done so much, and you can't be able to express his goodness. Give me Psalms 22. Psalms 22, verse 22. How to express our gratitude to God. The Bible says, I will declare your name to my brethren. That I will come to Imara Daima and I will express the goodness of the Lord. I will tell you people what the Lord has done. As long as I'm not lying, but I stand with the goodness by the rod of, you know, the God or our God, I will be able to tell the goodness of the Lord in the presence of brethren. You come to a church, the Bible says, in the midst of the assembly, I will praise you. Praise God. That you come here, some of you have been blessed. Some of you, the Lord has done so much. You think he was blessing you so that you keep quiet. He wants somebody to get to serve him because of what he's doing. Some of us people who get saved because of what the Lord is doing in their lives. And that's why I said it's no longer the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, but the Lord of Charles. You know, when I become one tomorrow, then I want you to serve God because of what he's doing in my life. That a generation is lifted because God has touched a person. You get into a territory and people just get amazed at what God is doing. At your workplace, people just decide to serve your God because of what the Lord has done in your life. So you must tell us exactly what the Lord has done. And therefore he says in the midst of the assembly, I will be able to declare. I will declare what? Your name, my God. Praise God. It is good to be able to just testify. You don't have to wait until you buy a car. That's when you want to come and tell us here. You, the fact that at least you woke up very well in the morning and you are sure there is lunch and there is dinner today without going to work. My friend, it's not obvious that on a Sunday you rest, you still have food for lunch and there's some food for supper. I tell you, you must declare the Lordness of the Lord in the assembly of Christ. Give me Psalms 96 just to cover something. 96 verse 3. The Bible says, declare his glory among the nations, his wonders among all people. You have to declare to people, to territories must understand. You get to a place, people must discover there is somebody in town. They have to know there is a new sheriff. God has done something so powerful. In your family, people must know that there is God in that home. You get to a home where people do not know God, but then for some reason in your presence, the Lord, you come carrying somebody so great than he who is outside. And people get to discover you are not the person they knew. They discover there's something great you are harboring in your life. They discover there is something unique you are carrying, because your life is just blessing. Your life is a miracle. And therefore, he said, declare his glory among the nations and his wonders among all people. Praise God. You cannot keep quiet. But the Lord has done to you, you've been promoted to another level. And for some reason, you are not here to brag. It is not here that because you are showing off. No, it is just to give glory and honor to him. That I'm here, I'm standing because of him. I will thank him because he's done so much. And therefore declare his glory among the what? Among the nations. Territories must know there is God. And you are home, people must discover that my son has got somebody. That's something your parents will come to know, that if they did not serve God, they have to break camp and come, because there is somebody you are carrying in that place. Praise God. You speak in your family and people must know that you alone as somebody so special in your life. Praise God. I will thank him. I will declare his greatness in the land of the living. He has covered me. He has protected me. I will not die, but I will live to declare his greatness. It is that the Lord is telling us. Let us speak of his greatness. Let us speak of his goodness. Let's be able to express his love that is done to us, to the people, so that people can know, oh, there is something more than just the knowledge. There is something more than just education. I've discovered there's something just more than just connections. And therefore, there is God that we need to serve. Praise God. Are we getting something? You know, that's what I tell people. The difference where people start together, but people don't finish at the same time. I always tell people there is a reason. The difference is knowing God. You start together, but you don't finish together. Others still have a lot of distance to cover. Others are ahead of the rest. But the reason, the difference is about the relationship with God. That definitely will make the difference. That is the game changer. You know him, plus whatever you have in your terms of education, you are ahead of everyone else, because the God is faithful and this God is good. And therefore I would encourage all of us, when you heard Reverend asking us to testify of his goodness, others are holding back. You are holding back God's goodness. Do you know how God is feeling? You think it is by your might, therefore you don't want people to know. Sour, you remain in that space. Come out and tell people what God has done, that he healed me. I was sure I was sick, but that is it. It's not bad to tell people that you are unwell. Praise God. And it doesn't matter with whichever disease. It's so much. There is a better report you can get from God than the one you have from the doctors. I know him. Tell God you are the one. Praise God. That is the thing that I wanted us to understand. That as you express your thanksgiving to God, you must be able to give, testify before the brethren. Number two. We give our thanksgiving and gratitude through songs and praises. Songs and praises. Praise God. It is not the ones that we sing here together. There is a time you just sit somewhere and you just find yourself just singing because of God's goodness. How many times you are doing your work, but you just feel like you have no thing to think about. You're just singing to the Lord. You're just praising the name of the Lord. You are just singing to him because he is good. And that's why it says, as we started in Colossians, you remember we're saying that as you sing hymns and psalms, you sing it as though you're doing it to the Lord. You express your love to him through praise and songs, because God is God. If you give me Psalms 105 verse 2. Psalms 105 verse 2. Psalms 105 verse 2. The Bible says, sing to him. Sing psalms to him. Talk of all his wondrous works. Praise God. You know, sometimes it's not just singing the normal song, but as you sing, you count your blessing. You count the things the Lord has done. You praise him and just give him, lift his name. Because he has done so much in your life this year, that even as you come to the end of the year, all that you need to give to him is songs and praises. And as you praise him, as you give him hymns and psalms, it is because of his wondrous deeds that he has done. And that is one way of expressing your gratitude to God. That God, I cannot give you anything else, but I will sing to you. David sang his head out. He did so much that he really, because he was enjoying the greatness of the Lord. If you read the book of Exodus chapter 15, I think verse 21, the Bible says that the song of Miriam, you know, when the horses and chariots of Pharaoh were hurled into the ocean, into the sea. Oh, it reached a point when the Israelites crossed. And you know, Miriam came out singing and women joined him. Because he said, come and see what the Lord has done. That indeed the Lord has done it for us. It was not easy. It was not just obvious. But for some reason we have crossed. And we will thank the Lord. Exodus chapter 15, verse 21. I reflect so much on that. Because when I remember, you know, what kind of song that Miriam sang. You know, she was so excited about what the Lord has done for them. It is not automatic that the ocean can hear or the sea can hear and people can cross. Praise God. It is not obvious that 2022 can hear you when you cross and get in. It is not automatic. As you cross, you will be able to sing songs of having. You know, there are people who remained in the year 2021. But you come and say, God, we crossed. The Lord, we passed. The Lord, we managed. And therefore, that is a song I want us to have. Exodus 15, verse 21. This should be your song. As you get into 2022. You go there and women will join you as you celebrate a newborn baby. You've never been seen having a child. But for some reason, and Miriam answered to them, sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. The horse and his rider has been thrown into the sea. And even as you read the previous verses, you will hear how she did her timbrel or her harps and songs and everything else, and women joined her. I pray that you are joined by women as you celebrate your baby, as you come up, as you do baby showers, and you have those new house and everything else. We'll be able to do what? To just give him thanks. Praise God. You will sing songs of praise because he has done it. You don't just keep quiet. Tell people, sing. He has triumphed. He says that for the he has triumphed gloriously. He is not just triumphed, gloriously. There is a way God just comes, he comes with his style. You know, when he arrives, people must know that God, there is God indeed. You know, time comes, you say, no, this one is not normal. Because the way the Lord lands in your family, and you wonder, but how? How did this happen? Praise God. And that's what we pray as you go to 2022. As you cross, I pray that this may this go with you. That you will be able to understand that, yes, there is so much sicknesses and diseases. The devil did not want you to cross, but the Lord dealt with that. The God handled that situation. God was able to manage that. And you crossed so gloriously that you can express your songs and praise to him. Praise God. That is one thing that I want to encourage all of us. Sing to the Lord. Give him thanks. Just praise him. If you give me Psalm 69:30. As in just some of the verses, you just remember. The verse, I will praise the name of God with a song, and will magnify him with thanksgiving. There's a way you don't just sing, you magnify, but with thanksgiving. You know, when you give thanksgiving, you magnify your love for him. You know, magnification, you enlarge it. You say, God, I'll not just sing, but I will be able to talk of your greatness. I will thank you. And therefore, as you give him praise, as you worship him, you praise him knowing very well you are giving thanks. Praise God. The Bible, that's what the Lord is telling us. That after you build all those houses, you've eaten and you're full. Don't forget God. You know, some of us here, we take things for granted. People invite you to a place. Not always when you go to an uncle's place and you get something to eat. You know, it's not always when you get to a friend's place and you have something to go back with. You thank God. After you build those good houses and you stay in them, you don't. Is that not what in the book of Deuteronomy? He says that they don't remember him. Or some of us are still not in the new houses, so you're not thanking God. By faith, thank God. 2022 is your year. I'm telling you, if you do not have enough food, 2022, thank in advance. If you do that, this God will rejoice. This God will be very happy. He will be able to say, my son, my daughter, because of your praises and because of your songs, I will be able to come through for you. That is my prayer for you. And then finally, number three, through your seeds and giving. Through seeds and giving. That is a way of expressing your love for God. How do you thank God? How do you come to the house of the Lord? Your seed or your giving? Praise God. Ama hapo sasa tempo imenda chini. Na niliweka mwisho kwa sababu nilijua that has to come last. Kuna tu vile nilisema hiyo lazima ikuwe mwisho. Because I know when it comes to that. And Rabbi will shock you. I was in a church at home last weekend. And I was surprised. You know, when people were running commitments for the year from October, guys were pledging.
But I was surprised that even people were pledging a million. And they are told you have to finish this thing before 31st. And I'm like, come on, in the village. You can't be serious. Some people have said that I had a contract of like over 10 million in the year. Not those who work even with the county. Somebody said, well, giving a million to God is not something I would take charge. But then you're in the city. This is New York of Kenya. As in honestly, we are in New York. Because of what? See, New York is a land of opportunities. You are in the city of Nairobi. And you're told 2,000 shillings and you still be able to think and you have to consult. Praise God. As in honestly. Do you want God also to consult whether to bless you or not? As in honest, that's what I always ask myself. People are pledging. I have a friend of mine who's saying that I've pledged 150, but I'm almost there. And every Sunday, they are reading those things. They read that thing in the church. I can't lie. It's God. I'm a Christian. And I will tell you, I was surprised that people give commitments, and they're calling it Thanksgiving for the year. They have no idea what that will do, but for some reason, they have to thank God. Praise God. But here, at least here, we know he's going to buy land. Honestly, how much more do you want to hear from Reverend? He's telling you this man is going to buy the land. And you're still not able to give your money. As in, let us be able to rise above this pettiness. We have to come out of our comfort zone. Because there is a reason why we have to thank God. You cannot buy life. You cannot heal your diseases and sicknesses. He is the one who can deal with that situation. Praise God. I said insurances sometimes get exhausted. There are so many times I've been told your cover is done. But you are still sick. There are so many occasions where I'm told you have to merge your cover here and there. And that's why I say it's still not always enough. Praise God. But I thank God that even you do not even have one. Why can't you take one from God? As in honestly, there are people here. I'm not saying even if I have. But some of us do not have any cover. Run. Get something from God. He is the best insurer. He is the best protector. He is the best deliverer. He will redeem you. Your lives were empty. I'm telling you, it was handed down by your forefathers. It had nothing. And that's why if you read the book of 1 Peter, he said in your empty lives, you are nothing. But for some reason, he said Jesus Christ was established before the foundations of the earth, has been made known in these recent times because of you. And therefore, even as you serve God, serve him knowing very well, it is all about you. You must serve him with your seeds. You must serving with your tithe. You must serving with your giving. How you do it, it is between you and your God. And therefore, we encourage us. Please seize the moment. Because we have to invest something to be able to draw something. And therefore, as we partner with God, let's trust in him. Psalms 116, verse 17 and 19, as I finish. Psalms 116, 17, 15. I will offer to you the sacrifice of thanksgiving. And I will call upon the name of the Lord. Praise God. You know, there are people who give God things which even them, they don't want to, they cannot give themselves. As in, I don't know whether is that English? There are things you give God that you cannot even give yourself. You get what I'm saying? As in, if you desire to get the best, but then you are giving God something as though you are doing him a favor. He said, I will offer to you the sacrifice. And he's not writing an offering. He's using the word sacrifice of thanksgiving. So therefore, as you come before the Lord, as you thank him in the end of the year, what is it you want to do? You have to think and come before God with something. Praise God. Amen. Therefore, he says that I will offer to you and I will call upon the name of the Lord. Next verse, verse 18. He says that I will pay my vows to the Lord now in the presence of all his people. I will pay my vows to the Lord. Hey, no wonder these guys were making promises. I discovered the reason why they were making pledges is because they have to give thanks to the Lord. I will pay my vows. What did you promise God? I have no idea what you are looking for and what you committed to God. You have to be able to honor your part of bargain. If you tell God, if you give me a child, I will thank you. If you give me a car, I will bless you. I will give you. That is one thing you have to honor. And therefore, he said, in the presence of all the people, let us know exactly what is it that you are committing to God. You can come and just say, God, it's been a journey. It's been a year. It has been a time, actually, moments of difficult situation. But I will thank the Lord. Praise God. In verse 19. In the courts of the Lord, Lord's house, in the midst of you, O Jerusalem, praise the Lord. Praise God. That you praise the name of the Lord because of what he's doing. Thank you. As I finish. Praise God. That you must come to God with thanksgiving. You don't just come thank somebody without something. Praise God. Praise God. I always say there is some level of sacrifice. And I keep on repeating that ata kama unafanyiwa harambee, lazima ulete chai. lazima ununue mkate. Hata kama utakopesha, we know you need money. We are aware you lack. But we cannot come to your house and you tell us you don't have something for the visitors. It's you, I don't know how you will get it. But for some reason you have to treat your people. Because that is what it means. You have to sacrifice to be able to be blessed. How comes you are always receiving? Better to give than to receive. And therefore, even as we come to support you, we are aware we have come to bring you money. But we have also something to eat from you. How you will get it, we have no idea. If you are going to borrow, borrow. At least you have to prepare for us some tea. So that at least we are happy. You cannot call people in the name of Arambe or anything else. And you are always, surely, we know you don't have. But we are coming. You have also to bless us. That is it. That is the law of natural justice. That for some reason you also have to give for people to appreciate you. Praise God. That is one thing that we say you come to the house of the Lord. We know you cannot outgive God. We know you cannot outbless God. But you must be able to bring something to be able to get something in return. That is one thing I have been taught, and that's something that I know. If you give me Amos chapter 4 verse 5, as you give me Amos chapter 4 verse 5 as I finish. Amos chapter 4 verse 5. He says, offer sacrifice of thanksgiving with living. Proclaim and announce the free will or offering. For this is you children of Israel, says the Lord. Offer sacrifice of thanksgiving. Praise God. This is biblical. You know, when you are told you come to the presence of the Lord with something, you don't just come because you are coerced. It is biblical. And therefore, all this Bible, whatever, is come to him with something. You must be able to come there at least knowing very well that you are expecting from the Lord. But you come there with a sacrifice. When you sacrifice, it means you are going out of your way. You are giving more than what you ordinarily would give. You are giving more than what you would give under normal circumstances. But you are going out of your way because, you know, 2022, I did get a house, I have to secure it. I did get a good health, I have to cover that in 2022. So this is the time. You put things here, knowing very well you are getting there in victory. And God will come gloriously. He will come for you. And I wanted to say Psalms 95 as we finish. In summary, I will say that all come. Let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout joyfully to the rock of our salvation. Next verse. You say, let us come before the presence with thanksgiving. Let us shout joyfully to him with psalms. In verse 3, it says here that for the Lord is the great God and the great King above all gods. If you want to try your connections and your networks, he is above all. He is the greater one. Let us come before him. Let us serve him. He says that in his hand are the deep places of the earth. The heights of the hills are his also. So that's why we call him the lily of the valley. He is the great I am. This God, you can call him and he comes. When you provoke him, he will speak in your life. And therefore, go knowing very well that you are serving him in these times, knowing what he has done for us, but knowing there is a journey ahead of us. Unless his presence go with us, I'm sure we may not succeed. But this God, we have to appreciate him. We have to thank him. Finally, verse 5, it says that the sea is his, for he made it, and his hands formed the dry land. So there is no resources and anything else that does not belong to the Lord. And therefore, as we come before him, let's come with thanksgiving. Praise God. Amen.
Praise God. Can we put our hands together to just appreciate Pastor Charles?